Hi guys, it's Debbie, and today I would like to talk about Dragon Ball Super Broly, directed by Tatsuya Nagamine. It is the latest hit in the Dragon Ball world created by Akira Toriyama. Before jumping right into the review, remember that in the description box below, you will find the link to Pampling, where you can find a ton of Dragon Ball inspired merch, ranging from posters to t-shirts and pullovers, socks and shoes, and so much more, along with thousands of other designs, such as the one on the t-shirt I am wearing today. Everything discounted with the code you will also find in the description box below. Now, in Dragon Ball Super Broly, the plot revolves around some of the most famous characters in the Dragon Ball universe, so Goku, Vegeta, Frieza, as well as Broly, a warrior who is gifted with an exceptional strength, a power beyond that the other characters could ever imagine. As the plot unfolds, we discover who Broly is, his rough past, and why he became who he is, and how his course of life ends up crossing the one of some of the old favourites and what their strengths combined can create. This film arrives in cinemas after 30 years of Dragon Ball history, which covers thousands of products ranging from mangas, films, series, to games, video games. The universe, the lore surrounding this world are so extensive that only those who have consistently kept up with most of the works know all the details. Now, I grew up in Italy, where the only choice of cartoons during my childhood were anime. Anybody who, like me, has lived their childhood in Italy at least over 15 years ago can confirm that we simply had no other option. There were no American TV shows for kids. We just got to see anime on TV. And then because of this huge love for the world of Japanese shows, Italy offered, and still offers, a ton of products relative to all this world. So we were basically surrounded by the world of anime. I will leave a link in the description box below to another video in which I speak about this more. But all of this means that I knew what Dragon Ball was. I watched some episodes back at the time. I knew the characters' names, the opening theme, but just because people around me watched it, I wasn't particularly into it. I watched some more episodes more recently, about 2 years ago, but this is more or less where my Dragon Ball knowledge stops. So I watched this film as a person who basically does not know anything about the story behind the film, about the Dragon Ball history, so I will review it as a newcomer. So the first thing I'd like to say is that even with my very limited knowledge regarding the background to this film, I was able to enjoy it, and that means a lot. First of all, the most impressive feature in this film is the animation. The colours and the drawings really catch the eye and keep the viewer's attention constant, both in the more dynamic scenes, such as the battle ones, in which the colours highlight the strength of the characters fighting, their movements, as well in the more common daily life scenes. The colours were very vibrant and definitely drew our attention to the idea of energy, a very important concept in the Dragon Ball world, as nearly all the characters or creatures we meet have some form of power, highlighted through different shades. The other feature I really appreciated in this film was the humanity with which the characters were portrayed. Nearly all the characters had an impressive emotional depth, which was explored even in the simplest moments. For example, there is one nearly comedic instance in which a more malicious character confesses something we would find rather childish. And at first it sounds like a simple, easy comedy plot filler moment, until you realise it was inserted to ridicule self-centered leaders who in reality are not as confident as we would expect, and whose hearts are poisoned by envy. So the film ends up being way more serious than it appears at first glance, and the analysis of the character pops up in different moments throughout the story, with different interpretations of the idea of manipulation, of making life-changing choices for others, pride and jealousy. The highlight of the story, especially under this perspective of the breakdown of the identity, happens with the character Broly, who has a very intriguing and mysterious personality. At first, he is misunderstood by many who regard him as more of a monster, a brainless hulk, while in reality his issues are much deeper. So I found this film both fun and serious. I always found my eyes to be moving around the screen, taking in more and more details. I think one of the battle scenes was dragged out a little too long, but I also know from my limited Dragon Ball knowledge that the battle scenes are a very big component of the Dragon Ball world, so drastically cutting them down for this film wouldn't have made any sense. Speaking of my Dragon Ball knowledge, I must admit that as a person who knew basically nothing about the characters, it was hard to keep up with the plot in certain points, especially at the beginning of the film when the characters were being introduced. There were some points in the film in which there was obvious exposition for the newcomers, but I still think this film is best viewed by those who are fans of this world. Let me explain this better, because this is not a new occurrence in the world of media. The most extreme example of this is the Harry Potter world. If you were to pick up with the Harry Potter saga after 6 books or at the 8th film, you would realize it would be impossible to keep up with the story. But at the same time, it would be impossible for the creators to get you up to date with all the information in the film, with a decade of information. But then there are films such as the latest Star Wars chapters, which are best viewed by fans of that world, but that can also be seen as standalone movies, so by newcomers to the series. And this is more or less a similar situation to the new Dragon Ball film. All the features I highlighted about Dragon Ball Super Broly make it less pretentious. This film is not being marketed as a niche product only for diehard fans, but it tries to be open to a wide audience. If you watch Star Wars The Last Jedi as a newbie, you will still enjoy it, but it will take a while to take everything in, while as a diehard fan it will be a downhill ride. And the same is for this Dragon Ball film. And if the Dragon Ball saga has been going on successfully for basically 35 years and it's still achieving a huge success, they must be doing it right. The fans are still crowding cinemas, newcomers are being welcomed, and this film was released just a couple of weeks ago and the positive reviews are pouring in. It has definitely created a very affectionate fandom, and we live in a moment in which fandoms die out very quickly. Remember the Hunger Games excitement just a few years ago and of how nobody basically talks about it anymore. I guess the affection for the Dragon Ball saga is due to a very deep and strong characterization of the subjects, with an enrichment of their personality over the course of time, an evolution in the quality of the animation, feeling of building a little group of friends the viewers can feel part of. So to sum it all up, I enjoyed Dragon Ball Super. I would have enjoyed it more with more information under my belt, but the fact that I was able to regardless means a lot. So whether you're a newcomer or a diehard fan, I would recommend trying it out. Have you already seen this film? Are you planning on watching it? What do you expect from it? Let me know everything with a comment down below. I hope you enjoyed this video. If you did, make sure to subscribe and I'll see you soon. Bye.